Good morning. Today is August 29, 2020, and I'm in the garden to take a look at what I have in the garden. So that's pretty much the end of summer, and fall is just around the corner. So let's see what we have here. I have this plant that came back early this spring, and that's giant mustard. I heard about it that it is a self-sow onions. Onions, yes. I think onions. But that's an onion. Even though it's in the brassica family, you would think it is a banana, but it is not. I'm just seeing a worm on it. Don't know if you can see it. I'm not a big fan of worms. But yes, it grew in spring, a little bit late in spring, and now it's setting seeds. So it's a self-sow onions, and I like to have it in the garden so that, you know, I have constant supply of it. So I planted in 2018, if I recall right, and it came back in 2019. Some seed grew in 2019, set seeds, and this year I have this plant here as well. So I let it go to seeds, a few leaves, and let it go to seeds, and now we have it here. And the good things with those plants, when you let them go to seed, is they set seeds a lot. So it's barely drying. That seal this. So it's barely drying here. Let's open this. And you can see I'm not seeing anything inside. So that means that seed fell already. But that's pretty much it. What I like to do though is, I like to use something to support the stems so that the seeds scatter in the area that I want them to grow, because I don't know if I'll come around here, cut the stem and scatter the seed myself. I'm not sure I'll do that, so I don't want the seed to fall in the pathway. So I'll just use the plant around to support it, to move it more toward the beds where I want that to grow. And where you can see, I don't have raised bed or anything like that. So I have just wood log from the property, just by cutting some tree down or some branches down. I just use them to limit the bed and the pathway so that the kids can know where they should walk or not walk. Not that it helps though, because when it comes to kids, they can walk everywhere they think they can pull their feet. But yeah, so that's one way that I try to see where I can grow and where I should walk as well. So that's our giant mustard. It does wild leaves. It grows like wild leaves, but when it starts setting seeds, the leaves will decrease size and be this slender. And it does have another worm here. So that's one of the reasons that I don't grow a lot of onions in my garden, because they are just prone to those type of pests. Cabbage, broccoli, you just grow them, and then you'll have cabbage worm and things like that, or fly. So, and I just prefer my perennials. They are not prone to those type of pests much, and there's not much to do. So, and when I see those things, I don't even bother them. Like, not much I can do about them. So just let them alone. The plant is doing its things, they are doing their thing. So yeah, if I pass around and I see some dry pad, I can just crush it to see if I will see some seed, and I'll just scatter it in the garden. And that's an annual, so that means it's not going to grow in fall, but in spring, those seeds that will scatter on the ground now will grow in fall. Like, no, it will grow in spring next year. So that's one way I'm trying to let those onions that easily self-sow to, you know, to grow in the garden. That way they just have to sow themselves year after year without me buying the seed or harvesting the seed and planting them early in the spring, because those plants, they are part of the nature. They know the right time for them to go dormant and the right time for them to wake up. So letting them just adjust to my style of gardening is my goal. And when I buy seed and I plant it, I like to let the plant go to seed so that I can harvest my own seed, because those generations will be more, it'll be easier for them to grow in my garden, because they just grew in that environment. So they are a lot easier to deal with than seeds that I purchased, as they came from plants that were baby sat. So that were like tendered too much. So it's not the way I deal with my garden. And if you are trying to grow your own vegetables, you can. You just have to see what works for you. And this is what works for me. I like to grow my own vegetables, but I like to do it as passive as possible without trying to intervene too much between the plants and the nature. I just like to see, observe them, how they are growing, if they need my help at all. And I just stay on the side, observe them and take notes. So when they dry, then I know around what time of the year they get their seeds ready and what time of the year they grow in the garden. And I know for a fact that it will come back in spring. The seed will fall in the ground in fall, but the plant will grow in spring. So that's an annual. And that self so, and I just want to increase the number of the plants in my garden so that I have another vegetables, another green that I can use as a replacement of spinach in my cooking and lettuce in my salad. Thank you for watching. I'm Afiavi Ojune Liberman, creators of Liberman Consulting LLC YouTube channel and owners of Nina Soap. And our website is ninasoap.com. We have a natural product online store as well. And we sell natural products, including towels that you can use as individual towels to wipe your hand in the bathroom so that you don't share germs with everybody using the bathroom, whether they wash their hand clean or not. And that simple thing that I'll show you, I believe I have a second one on another side of the garden that is setting seed. So that, let's go take a look at it to see how it is doing. If I can spot it, and it is not this. Well, I cannot see it here, but it was somewhere here before, unless it is done completely. I'm not seeing it here. So the only one that I'm certain of is the one that we just saw. So thank you so much for watching. You can visit our website ninasoap.com to purchase our natural products. We have light soap there as well, or you can visit our apparel store, liberlabel.com, where we sell custom design apparel and stationery. Thank you. And thank you for watching our videos. Thank you for subscribing. Stay safe.